Maybe you think I choose Valvoline just for my purpose. Not true. I use Valvoline so I can slip into these really tight jeans. You see, in my profession, a radio announcer, a deep and resonant voice is everything. Sometimes slipping into jeans two sizes too small can be a bit tricky. That's where Valvoline comes in. So, whether it's pulling jeans up or getting them down without damaging God's great gift to me, my vocal cords, I choose Valvoline. Valvoline, you know what I mean.
You know, when you choose Valvoline oil, you're buying the best possible protection for the best possible price, which is why all these people choose Valvoline. People who know use Valvoline.
Maybe you think I choose Valvoline just for my purpose. Not true. I use Valvoline so I can slip into these really tight jeans. You see, in my profession, a radio announcer, a deep and resonant voice is everything. Sometimes slipping into jeans two sizes too small can be a bit tricky. That's where Valvoline comes in. So, whether it's pulling jeans up or getting them down without damaging God's great gift to me, my vocal cords, I choose Valvoline. Valvoline, you know what I mean. Maybe you think I choose Valvoline just for my car. Not true. I choose Valvoline for everything. And I do mean everything. Powerboats, tractors, sailboats, radio executives, women who ring up on the telephone and who really piss me off, cornflakes, really just about everything. Valvoline. You see, when you rub people up the wrong way as much as I do, you need a good social lubricant. And the best social lubricant is Valvoline. Valvoline. You know what I mean. Maybe you think I choose Valvoline just for my cars. Not true. I use Valvoline so I can slip into these really tight jeans. You see, in my profession, a radio announcer, a deep and resonant voice is everything. Sometimes slipping into jeans two sizes too small can be a bit tricky. That's where Valvoline comes in. So, whether it's pulling jeans up or getting them down without damaging God's great gift to me, my vocal cords, I choose Valvoline. Valvoline, you know what I mean.
I'm sorry, 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 Storm MP.
I try.
Yeah. I used pink bathrobe. I wore mink snow. I smelled TV tray. I bought on eBay. My house is filled with this crap. Shows up in bubble wrap. Most every day, what I bought on eBay.
Tell me why I need another padlock. Tell me why I got that alarm clock. Tell me why I bid on Shatner's old toupee. They had it on eBay.
I bought your knickknack. Just check
my feedback. A plus plus. They all say they love me on eBay. Gonna buy a slightly damaged car. Gonna buy some Beanie Babies new tag from some guy I've never met in Norway. Found him on eBay.
Is liable to snipe. Would you
seconds left to go. Whoa. Got big power visa, whatever will please ya, as long as I've got the dough. I buy your tchotchkes, some your watch, please. I buy.
I'm not afraid. Thank you. Yeah. can see the world that they want on the bed. It's a hush, they're laying on the floor. They're whispering in my ear, they're telling you all they know.
And I don't think I'll be coming back again. Nostromo ship's log. Stardate, morning tea break. Our hibernation was disturbed by the horror of Craig McLaughlin's new song on the ship's radio. But even greater terrors awaited us.
What was that?
It's a distress signal. There's a disabled ship on a nearby planet.
Don't get a fix on it, Kane.
Captain. Sounds like... There's... Star the fun ship.
There's so much more on the one ship.
We'll have to go down to the Fair Star and investigate. It's going to be dangerous.
They're all dead. What do you think could have wiped out the entire crew of the Fair Star?
Happy hour?
Look.
Oh, my God.
Damn good. I can't get this alien off Kane's face.
Son. Let me have a go.
Go and make a distress call to Earth or something, would you?
My God, that special sauce eats right through.
Imagine what the pickles could do.
Oh, it's hideous. Look at the alien's face.
What are you talking about, Lambert? He's always looked like that.
Hey. I feel great.
We've got to do something to try and stop
them. That alien's mutating. It'll kill us all.
I wasn't talking about the alien. I was talking about Lambert screaming.
I'll ask the computer for help.
Do it.
What does it say?
Insufficient funds. Contact your bank manager. Hang on. Working. Go down into the really dark, scary part of the ship all by yourselves without any weapons. Walk around backwards, especially into the area where the weird slobbering noise is coming from. Yeah.
Okay. So it's the same as last time. Makes sense to me. Let's go.
Wipe out the crew.
Dallas has been turned into McNuggets and Lambert has been filleted fish. I have no option but to activate the self-destruct mechanism.
Warning, this ship will be destroyed in 2 minutes.
2 minutes? We can do this place in half that time.
What's up your ass, bigger friend?